Okay, here we are back on the coast.
Why don't you arrest us, Aveline?
What?
We break the law. I'm pretty sure. There are laws for almost everything. You're not a bad guard, are you?
No.
That's good. Is it because you're fond of Hawk? I kind of am.
How very nice for you. Keep it to yourself.
I'd rather keep it with her.
Okay, we're back here on the coast. Because there were, I mean, for two reasons, I'm hoping to maybe salvage the items that I didn't get a chance to pick up last time I was here. I mean, it's not likely. Things like that don't always stick around in games like this. This isn't like the Elder Scrolls or Fallout games, new ones anyway, where all the stuff that you drop has a tendency to stay, or at least a good chance of staying where it goes. Ah! Still here. Nice. Killed a lot of people here last episode, and I didn't have any room in my inventory, so I couldn't pick any of it up. But then I made the mistake of ending the jumping back. Rune of Fire Warding, huh? Jumping all the way back to the Kirkwall instead of looting the corpses and maybe finding a way to take the stuff that I wanted, because I had a lot of garbage that wasn't really worth anything. I could have just thrown away daggers and pieces of armor that had no use to me as armor and would only sell for one bronze piece, so it wasn't really worth even keeping around. But I sold all that stuff in the interim between that episode and this one, so we are good to go and pick this crap up. Yeah, I think I got it all. There was also another quest that I want to do here. It was one we picked up a couple of episodes ago, where we ran into a dwarf who was having dealings with Qunari, the Arashocker, whatever you want to call him, of the Qunari, that he had a deal with them that he wants to go and procure black powder or gunpowder, some sort of explosive powder.
I don't even wake Bianca for every threat anymore.
The dwarves, for all that they resemble the sort of...
No further, human. Talvishoth control these passages.
I am more than capable of meeting any threat.
So I see. I expected to warn a caravan, not a well-equipped tracker. The path ahead is littered with my kind. If you are as skilled as you look, it would please me if you killed them.
You have turned your back on your kin?
Yes, for a second time. I did not like my role, so I left the cube. I do not wish to be a murdering thief, so I left these Talvishoth to warn their victims. You are no victim, so now I will leave.
If they have offended you so much, help me go after them.
But I am worse. They don't want to raise their swords for coin, so they murder and steal. They cling to the honor they held under the Qun. My sword means nothing. I will sell it and myself as mercenary. Qunari would say I am worse.
If your blade is on the market, I'll pay.
No.
You sure you know what mercenary means?
Taking payment to face Talvishoth only proves that I've sold the last of myself. I know what I am. I don't need to belabor it. You have my word of caution, human. Heed it or do not.
The more they talk, the less I understand.
Okay, that was one Qunari that was somewhat atypical. For the most part, Qunari are so honor-bound by their code that they refuse to do anything that even deviates from it in the slightest way. Sten was ready to basically, live in exile simply because he didn't have his sword. And we're seeing the same kind of thing at a lot of the Qunari that were running around here. This one was a little bit different, not... he, I guess, has a certain mode of conscience about him. Doesn't want to just pillage and kill people in order to take their money and their belongings and all that kind of stuff. But still motivated by a certain ethical point that doesn't want to... it's going the wrong way. Doesn't want to entirely betray that. Although, I mean, that does the point really make a difference at that point? Because, I mean, he's like, go up there and kill them. Well, anyway, let's go up there and kill them. We gotta go and get this black powder thing done. The dwarves, they are... Talvashoth. Here we go. Qunari! Don't run past them, jeez. The dwarves in this game, despite a sort of similarity to a lot of dwarves that you see in a lot of fantasy fiction and all that kind of stuff, like living underground and mining for things and having some weird connection to the rock or some crap like that, do have one thing that's different about them. They don't have the power to do a lot of things like use gunpowder or explosives for mining or anything like that. Oh, well, unaffected, huh? What is happening here? Attack him! That was weird. I couldn't attack him. Okay, I'll do this as Aveline then. It's like a secret passage. He survived. So that dwarf made a deal with the Qunari, who do possess the technology of explosives. And, well... everything is not going out too well here. How many Qunari were on that ship? Jeez. How many have I killed so far? Okay, we're back in a cave. Garbage sword. Actually, we started a little bit into that, you see? Alright. See if there's anything in here. Nope. One of the things we're going to notice over and over again in this game as we get further and further into it is that we are reusing the same environments over and over and over again. It may not be immediately noticeable now because it's only the second time that we've ventured into this cave, but we will see this cave again and then again and then again. And they think they can sort of get away with this, the designers, I mean, by going and just starting you off in different portions of the cave, and then you go and music changed weirdly. By starting you off in different portions of the game and then going and like running you to a different location as far as like the destination. Now it was probably the result of some sort of like they didn't have the budget to create environment after environment, or maybe they thought that if we do this with a bunch of different environments, we're going to have to do bug testing for each environment and all that kind of stuff. And it would just end up being too much for the development of this game, which, in a way, came out rather quickly, fairly quickly after the game Dragon Age Origins, which had a much larger scope to it. Oh, Meryl got stuck by a trap. Okay. I know this isn't the way to go, but I want to check it out anyway. Now, since you start off in a different section, and you end up in a different section... Oh, raw lyrium. That's dangerous. You can't, you'll oftentimes simply not run across the same section of the cave that you were in before. But you will eventually go through these things so many times that you'll start to notice that you're running over the same spots over and over again. And that was one of the major criticisms of this game. Silverite. That you're... It's nothing's really, original. Get out of the way. There's nothing this way, is there?
Everyone stay still and try not to make any loud noises.
Do I really want to go this way? Just running in the areas I don't need to be in. Or is this where I came from? That's where I came from. Jeez, I'm getting lost in my own playthrough. Alright, there we go. Oh, I remember this part. Ah, shit. I wanted to cure Varric. Didn't affect everybody. Ew, what was that? Looks like I might win anyway, but music changed because there's only one left.
I can't keep this pace.
Maybe one left down there. I see him on the radar. I can resurrect my friends by... Oh wait, no. Am I thinking of Dragon Age? I'm thinking of a different game. I thought I could resurrect them. I guess not. Oh! Cerebos!
This is wearing on me.
Cerebos is a mage of the Qunari. Where is it? Ah, he's got health potions, a bastard. Take him out, Aveline. Oh, shit. No one to back you up, Aveline. I almost got him, though. If I could just get one of these abilities back, I can do something about it. Got him! Ha 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 ha! Alright, we killed all these people. Aveline did it.
Trap.
Where? Oh, there it is. I wanted to cure Varric of his injury before we started. Now, most of my characters now have pretty been injured. Varric's got down to like half his health. I shouldn't have wandered away from Hawk. That's what allowed her to fall, and I tried clicking on Meryl even though I shouldn't have, and Meryl ended up going down. But whatever. We succeeded. All the Qunari are dead. Stuff! Give me all of your crap. Alright, let's go. Okay, we're gonna go to the docks. I don't think we've been here yet, have we? Alright, yeah, this is...
None of the ring have any lineage. It wasn't a big enough village to have a wall around it, let alone a place for elves.
Where did the elves live, then?
Stables and outbuildings, mostly.
I think I like alienages better.
Why? Alright. We're going to run into the Qunari for the first time. Not the Qunari that were out there. The group of Qunari that have basically... They hold up on the docks and they've been living in this compound right here. They gate their area off so regular people can't just wander around in there.
I kind of like the Qunari.
Let me pass. I have business with the dwarf Javaris and your Arashok.
The short mouth, yes. Enter if you must, Basra.
Well, we just... The gate just disappeared. Well, these guys are scary.
Ah, my right hand arrives. Summon your Arashok. The bargain is done. About time you showed. I've been here for hours. Illustrious Arashok, I am here to report that your hated Talvashoth were felled, one and all. Right? Yes, they were. So, I'm ready to open negotiations for the explosive powder, as we agreed.
No.
He's not getting it. Say something.
You arranged this. You deal with it.
Well, you see, it is customary that effort deserves reward. I think I've shown how common need could benefit us both.
You asked for the Gatlock and were refused, so you invented a task and then paid to have it done. You failed your own goal. You have proved your wealth not worth, and Qunari still owe you nothing.
I did his dirty work. That debt stands.
Does it, dwarf?
You said yourself there was no bargain. I'm not getting a sodding thing out of this.
This human did what you could not, something I did not expect of any outsider, and you have involved me. If you made a bargain for the Talva Shoth, that debt for their lives will be honored.
It's not at all. Take your coin, take whatever. Hornhead Oxman and Mongrel Donglords, suck your own powder and blow your head off, sod it.
You will leave as well, human. There's no more coin for you here.
Qunari, these guys are awesome.
Let them wallow.
The whole idea of, like, the mercenary nature of us and the dwarf that they were dealing with and all that sort of disgusts this guy. He obviously doesn't like the idea of being stuck in Kirkwall and would do anything to leave if only he could. But anyway, 22 minutes is long enough.